Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I have a very special video planned out for you guys. I don't think I've done a video like this ever, but today I'm going to be talking about 10 Indian skincare brands that you need to try out. Now, these brands are brands that I don't think get enough clout. They don't spend enough money on their marketing and sponsored videos, and maybe that's why you've not heard about them. Now, obviously, you would have heard about some of them because the internet is blessed with people like Shweta Vijayanayar, who does talk about a lot of indie brands as well, and that's why I thought I should share my favorite with you as well, because I think they deserve all of the clout. I just want to say a couple of things before we begin this video, so I will have a timestamp right here so as to when I will start talking about the brand, so you can skip to that if you want, but I would really appreciate if you hear out this part. Now, I just want to say, in today's world, it's already really difficult to have a brand because there are just so many brands. To stand out in that crowd, it's really difficult, and it's even so more difficult for an Indian brand because from first-hand experience, I can say this: as soon as you want some quality, some good ingredients, some natural pure form of anything, the cost of everything will go up because it's not diluted, it's pure. And as soon as the cost goes up, there's so many people who are like, why would I spend XYZ amount on an Indian brand when I can buy an Estee Lauder in that brand? I sort of get where all of those comments come from, but you have to understand it's not an easy job to formulate something, to take out the costings, to ensure that there is some profit margin for you as well, because let's be real, that's how businesses work. And you can't do mass manufacturing because you're not sure if there's an audience for it, and you can't keep everything on racks. There's a lot of things that goes into a business, guys, and we really need to start appreciating Indian homegrown brands for that. And secondly, you have to realize that everything that's DIY does not mean it's good. For example, a lot of brands that are more on the natural side, I know they get messages like, oh, you know what, I can just whip that up in my kitchen. I mean, yeah, all for DIYs. I love DIYs as well, but you have to understand, just because it's natural doesn't mean it's harmless. For example, we've all done this. We've put lemon on our face because everyone said it's good, but apparently that's the worst thing you can do. Lemon is not meant to go on your skin. It's very, very harsh on the skin. So yeah, that's what I'm trying to say. Everyone just says, you know, rather than using so many creams, I would just do some DIY. You can react to natural products as well. You have to realize that, because every skin is so different. Let's not get into that conversation. Let's talk about these brands. Let's give them their moment. Now, of course, there are brands like Everyouth and Biotique and Wow and Mamaearth that are more on the affordable side, but they're already so talked about. I thought, let's skip that. And then there's Kama Ayurveda and Foressential, which are more on the expensive side. So again, so let's just skip that. Let's talk about some indie homegrown brands, which also have some sort of certification to them. A lot of people just DIY up things in their kitchen and they're selling it these days. Honestly, I wouldn't put that on my skin. Until unless I know it's coming from a good source, I can't put that on my skin, because everything needs some preservative or something, or the formulation must be stabilized in order for it to be good for a period of time. So I'm very finicky now these days with what I'm putting on. Like, I'm not finicky, I just put whatever on my skin, but I know all of those things are applicable on the skin and they're not expired. So that was a long ass intro. So without any further ado, now let's just quickly get into the video. There's no particular order to this. All of these are amazing. You can check out the brands for yourself and select some products that you like for yourself. So let's go. The first brand I have is Plum. Now, I do think Plum is the more talked about brand in this video, but I still wanted to include this in my video because I really love this brand. Now, they have a lot of different lines, like white tea and chamomile. They have their green tea range, they have their illuminance range, and they're just killing it. They're vegan, they're PETA certified, and their formulations are just so beautiful. I especially love their hair care range, the olive and macadamia one. It's so good, you guys. Honestly, everything that I've tried from Plum till now has worked out so beautifully for me, especially their kajal. It's just bang on a beauty. So yeah, mostly I think you can try out anything from this range and you will love it. Next up, I have YBP. Now, this is one of those brands that is so niche. Just so, the product library is very small, but everything is just made with so much love and care. What I have right here with me is their guasa. This is the rose quartz spoon guasa. I have bought both of their guasas, even the amethyst one, because I really, really support the company. They also have their skin salves and their argan oil and whatnot, and they're just so beautiful. They're completely, completely pure and direct from the source. They're not diluted. So you would really see a miraculous difference on your skin once you start using it. They're blue tansy. I finished it in literally 1.5 months because my skin really, really needed it, because these winters were really harsh. Delhi was just not having it, and that oil literally helped my skin throughout the winters. Again, one of those brands where you can try anything from, and I'm sure that you would end up loving it. Then I have Juicy Chemistry with me. Now, this brand, I have to give you a heads up. Everything that they manufacture, it's so fresh, so pure. The maximum shelf life of a lot of things is just 6 months. So you have to ensure you don't have a lot of products with you. Because if you're someone like me, then you have a lot of products and then these products end up going to the back end and they will expire. So you have to ensure either you give these products a priority or you just finish out your stash first and then order these. Now, because this is a little bit too natural, you have to patch test it first and see if your skin agrees to it. Of course, patch testing is something you should do with everything, but these formulas are, again, as I said, a little too natural, so you must patch test these, because I've heard there have been a lot of people who thought the Juicy Chemistry is not something that suits their skin because it's a little too potent for them. So just make sure you select a product that is A, meant for your skin type, and then do a skin test as well, a patch test as well, and lastly just ensure you finish it up in 6 months. Then I have Jeva with me. Now, Jeva has been doing a lot of things. For example, this is their pure hyaluronic acid with vitamin A, E, whatnot, face serum. Then they are doing vitamin C and whatnot. I was already a huge fan of their face mask, their charcoal face mask, their green tea matcha face mask. I really like those. And even with these formulations, of course, these are a little watered down, I have to say, because they're so affordable. You probably can't afford to sell at what cost they're selling. But again, it's a really nice brand, especially if you're looking for something more affordable but not super bad chemically. They're more on the good side of things. Then I'm going to talk about Love Organically. I don't think a lot of you would have heard about this brand, but it's a very new baby brand, and they have these really beautiful face masks. I think I've tried all of their face masks and they're just so good, guys. They come in a powder formula, so you can literally mix it up with whatever suits your skin type. Water, rose water, milk, yogurt, whatever. They have mentioned everything on the back of their packages, and all of them are super natural but nicely mixed in with proportions that would be perfect for your skin. They also have body lotions and whatnot. I've not tried their body lotions, but their face masks, I would definitely say you should try them out. Next up, we have Indulgio. Now, I've talked about Indulgio so many times on my channel. I love their oils, their mists, their lip oil. It's just so good. If you want to get one thing, I would say get their rose gold oil. It's so good. Or get their lip oil. It's so, so good. Or maybe a face mist. Like, you have three different categories, right? So if you want to get just one thing from one category, rose gold oil, their lip topper, and their Roman witch hazel and chamomile mist. Love it so much. Again, it's one of those brands that everything has worked out so nicely for me, and I would really, really recommend this brand to everyone, especially if you have dry skin like mine. These oils are so good. The rose gold oil, oh my god, underneath makeup it just looks so beautiful. I literally stopped using a primer ever since I started using the rose gold oil, and I finished a bottle of rose gold oil. I've showed it in my empties. I've showed so many mist empties in my empties. But yes, a beautiful brand, homegrown, love it. Then we have Myoho, that is Pure by Priyanka. It's one of those brands that Shweta Vijay Nair did introduce me to, and I'm so thankful for that. Now, I have so many favorites from this brand. I love their rose blush pack. It's so good. Their aloe vera scrub, love it. I have finished their Good Hair Day shampoo because it just makes my hair actually have a good hair day. It's so, so, so good. It's a little bit on the thicker side. I wish the packaging was better on the shampoo, but other than that, the formula, it's just so good. I have the green tea toner with me, which just refreshes you up like no one's business. Like, you just spritz it over and you're just like, I'm fresh. It's one of those products. So again, you can just go ahead and search this brand and look for something that your skin type would agree to, because they have a huge library and they have so many different products for different skin concerns and types, and I'm sure you're gonna love it. Then I want to talk about Sugandha, which is such a beautiful niche brand, which is doing acid skincare, acid-based skincare like AHA, BHA, lactic acid, and all of those based skincare mixed with ingredients. For example, this is their BHA serum, which has 2% salicylic acid, gotu kola, and green tea. Now, they have so many different products. Again, you have to keep into consideration their expiry rates. Every product has a different expiry rate, so please do keep that into consideration. But if you're looking for acid-based skincare, if you're looking for something that would be sort of like a replacement for the ordinary in India, then this is the brand to go for. They have a beautiful library. They have so many products, so many different acids, so many different acid-based skincare products, from serums to lotions to face washes, that you will find something for your skin concern. AHAs and BHAs are great to retexturize your skin, fade acne, scarring and all of that. So definitely look into this brand if acne, scarring is something that concerns you. Then I want to talk about Global Beauty Secrets. I know the name says Global Beauty Secrets, but it's an Indian brand that is manufactured in India as well, but it uses secrets from all over the world. In my hand, I have the Indian toner. This is the milk and saffron toner, and it's so good. It's a moisturizing toner, so it doesn't feel dry on the skin, and it's in a spritz bottle. Love it. I've tried their face washes, the Azura Bean face wash from Japan, then their hair mask, their face mask, the clay mask. I've completely finished up the hair mask because in summers it was a boon, because it's a clay-based hair mask. It cleansed the scalp so well. So again, I don't think a lot of people are talking about this. You can search my name with these names, with these brands names, and about 80% of them I would have talked about. I've talked about Global Beauty Secrets. I did a paid partnership with them, but I used the product way in advance just to try it out and see how it works for me. Plum, I've talked 1,000 times about. Jeva, Indalgio, all of these brands are brands that I've been talking about for a while. These are things that I've been using for a while, seeing how they work, because skincare, it's just so time consuming. You really need to be sure when you're talking about something. So again, Global Beauty Secret again doesn't have a huge library. They've just launched soaps, and my father is loving them. So if you are into soap, then you should definitely check it out. Another Indian brand with a really nice concept. And the last brand I have is Ananda in the Himalayas. Now, this is owned by Ananda, the spa and everything that is actually in the Himalayas. They don't have a huge product library, but they have good products in the small library that I have. And that's what I've been appreciating more. If I see products that are actually, you know, people are taking out the time and the research work and everything on one product, you really put in a lot of effort and love into that one product, and it shows in the product and how it applies on the face. Ananda in the Himalayas is one of those company. What I have in my hand is the Juniper and Holy Basil Light Moisturizer. This is for oily and combination skin, so it's perfect for people who have, again, oily or combination skin, or live hot and humid areas. Now, I particularly use this in summertime. I have finished their body lotion, which is again a beautiful lotion. I don't like feeling greasy on my, I don't like feeling greasy anywhere. I'm not a greasy turkey, but their body lotion was so good. I've completely finished it up. Their oil, their body oil again was really beautiful. I think I showed it in one of my empties. Not really sure in which one, but I'm sure I have shown it. So yeah, again, a very beautiful and niche company with amazing products, including and incorporating Indian ingredients into it, like holy basil, which is basically Tulsi. So yes, those were the brands I wanted to talk about, give a shout out to. It is really difficult to stand out, be individualistic, and just create something new and something that is so you. And I completely understand that, because a lot of Indian brands, and it's really sad, I feel really sad when I say this, Indian brands feel it's okay to copy and just reproduce something. For example, when Plunge launched its sleeping masks and different masks, they completely copied Fresh and Too Cool for School blatantly. They didn't even felt the need to do the artwork again. They just picked up the artwork as well, and it really breaks my heart, because there's just so much talent in India, and I'm sure it's not that expensive as well, because of so much population. There's gonna be someone who's gonna do it for cheaper for you and still have a lot of talent. So I really feel bad when I see something of that sort's happening, and I really want to appreciate these brands for being individualistic, being original in their ideas, and just being who they are, killing the game of skincare in India and just launching something new and innovative for us. So yeah, that's gonna be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this and you found something new. You probably should check out these brands and support them, because make in India. I mean, it's a really huge deal. My own brand is made in India, no self promo, I'm just letting you know. Made in India is something that I really appreciate as well. A lot of these are made in India, owned by Indians, and just being run by Indians, and a lot of them are women headed as well. So all in for that. But yeah, that's gonna be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and if you did, then don't forget to comment and subscribe, and don't forget to show some love to these brands. I will also make sure I link their Instagrams in the bottom bar for you guys, so you can just go ahead and follow them and just show some love. Yeah, I mean, even if you don't end up buying anything, you can just give them a follow. That also really helps them out. It's word of mouth publicity. So yeah, that's gonna be a long ass intro as well, outro, a long ass outro as well. I'll see you guys next time. Till then, take care. I love you all so much. Mwah. Bye.